Hey guys, and welcome back to Space Nerd Confessions. I'm Cynthia, and today we're going to be talking about Air Force ROTC enlisted to officer scholarship programs. Yeah, that's a mouthful. So today I'm going to be talking about three different ROTC scholarship programs, and they apply to active duty Air Force enlisted personnel, but there's actually two of the three that apply to enlisted personnel in other branches. Also, I want to note that even though I'm just talking about three Air Force ROTC scholarships, different universities may have additional scholarship programs. So if you're interested in a specific university, or you are unable to apply for these certain programs, definitely do some research at your university of preference, or talk to an educational counselor to see what's available at your school. And last thing before I get started, there's a very, very important list of things to consider at the end of this video, so do not miss it. It's definitely some key pointers and notes that you need to keep in mind when applying for these programs. All right, so I'm gonna start off with two Air Force ROTC scholarship programs. They're very similar as far as the application process and what they do offer, but I will explain the differences between the two, which are very, very minor. But we have the ASCP and SOAR. So there's a lot of information in regards to these scholarship programs for ASCP and SOAR. So I did provide the link for both of the scholarship programs below. So if you want to reference it or you have any additional questions. So I'm going to break it down by who's eligible, what the service requirements are, what the academic requirements are, what the program has to offer, so what the benefits are for the scholarship program, and lastly, just a brief explanation of what the process for application looks like. So for the first thing I'm going to talk about is who is eligible for these programs, and then this is where the minor difference is between ASCP and SOAR. So SOAR is applicable to active duty enlisted airmen in the Air Force, and it requires approval through your wing leadership. And then the ASCP, it applies to active duty enlisted airmen, but it also applies to enlisted personnel in other branches. Next, I'm gonna be talking about service requirements, and I'm gonna start it off with the number one question that people typically ask, and that's about the age requirements. And for ASCP and SOAR, applicants must be under 31 for the year of their graduation. So by December 31st of your graduation year, you still need to remain under 31. I also wanted to note that for this age requirement, it is not waiverable. So that means there is no flexibility for going past the age requirement for ASCP and SOAR scholarship programs. Additional requirements are 1 year time in service, as well as 1 year time on station by the board convening date, which is December. Both of these items are waiverable, so there is flexibility for your application. For those on overseas short tours, there is a requirement that you have to complete half of your tour 1 month prior to your class start date. And then for those that are serving overseas on a long tour, there's a requirement that you need to apply up to 8 months out from your DROS. And both of the overseas requirements are waiverable. Applicants must be able to be recommended by your immediate commander, pass PT tests, and be medically qualified. A couple other service requirements include that applicants must not be selected for reassignment prior to their submission date for their applications, and also they need to have retainability. So they said no more than 30 days out from class start date. Lastly, applicants must not have any restrictions on their profile, such as UIF or AAC, and they must not have an IEB or SRB within their current enlistment. However, both of those items are waiverable. All right, next I'm going to be talking about the academic requirements for the ASCP and SOAR scholarship programs, with the first thing being that you must have a minimum of 12 credit hours with a cumulative GPA of 3.0. And for those that don't have a college background, please don't get turned off by the idea of 12 credit hours. That can be easily accomplished with 3 or 4 college courses. Another academic requirement is to meet the ACT, SAT, and AFOQT minimum scores. However, if you do have 24 college course hours or more, you do not need to have the ACT or SAT scores, just the minimum AFOQT scores. The minimum scores include the ACT is going to be 22, the SAT combined reading and math is going to be 1100, and for AFOQT, they're looking for an academic aptitude of 39 or greater. And for those that have 96 hours or more and they're within that last year of graduating, unfortunately you cannot participate in this program. And lastly, for the academic requirements, you must be able to complete your degree within 2 to 4 years and be considered as full-time by the university. And unfortunately, you're not able to pursue a second bachelor's degree or a master's degree in the ASCP or SOAR programs. All right, so you made it this far. Now that you have an idea of what the service requirements are and the academic requirements are, and you know that you're eligible for these programs, you may be wondering, well, what are these programs? What are the benefits? And what's the process going to look like? ASCP and SOAR are really cool programs, especially for those that really are excited about pursuing an education or a commission into the Air Force. So these programs, what they do is they're going to remove you from active duty, and then you'll be placed as a full-time student while you're pursuing your education. And then at the end, at the graduation, you will commission as an officer in the United States Air Force. So obviously you're going to need to choose a university that offers the Air Force ROTC, but if they don't, cross-town schools are also allowed. So obviously during your undergraduate degree process, you're going to be an Air Force ROTC cadet and a full-time college student. All right, so let's talk money. So the ASCP and SOAR scholarship programs, they both offer up to $18,000 per academic year for tuition. They also offer $900 per academic year for textbooks. And lastly, you do get a non-taxable stipend each month, varying from $300 to $500, and it depends on your student status. So as you go up from freshman to sophomore to junior to senior, the price will increase each month. I do want to note that room and board are not included in the Air Force ROTC scholarship programs. All right, so now that I got you guys hyped about these Air Force ROTC scholarship programs, I'm going to talk about the process and how to apply for them. So by getting involved with this process, it's important to keep in mind your base education office. Typically, they have someone dedicated for these scholarship programs. And also, it's important to get your supervisor involved or your leadership involved so they can help you as needed with your application also. Another thing to consider for the process is that the boards convene once a year. So typically, the packages are due between 1 September and 15 October. And also for the SOAR packages, because they do have to go through your leadership, they may have different deadlines, so make sure you know when your packages are due. And also for the SOAR packages, there are 51 allocations per year. For different MAGCOMs have a different number that they do select. And for the ASCP program, for fiscal year 16, 17, and 18, it was 100% selection rate. So keep that in mind. Another thing about the SOAR packages is that MAGCOMs typically look at the whole airman concept. They look at your ability to put the package together because it does require a lot of paperwork, but they also look at your commander's recommendation, your academic performance, and lastly, your job performance based on your primary duties. And one last note for the process is that waivers are permitted for certain criteria, but they are not guaranteed. All right, and I'm going to wrap it up with one last scholarship program. It's called POCERP. This one will be a lot more brief than my last discussion just because a lot of the requirements do mirror the ASCP and SOAR. All right, so who's eligible for the POCERP program? So it's still open to the active duty enlisted airmen, active duty enlisted personnel from other branches, and then also it could be applicable to those that may not meet the age requirements for ASCP and SOAR, since it's less stringent on the age cutoff. All right, and for the service requirements for the POCERP program, it's going to be the same as the ASCP and SOAR, with the change of just the age requirement, like I mentioned. So for the age requirement is that you need to be able to commission by the age of 39. And you can also get a waiver and bump that up to the age of 42. And for the academic requirements for the POCERP program is that you must have a cumulative GPA of a 3.0 or higher, and you must be able to complete your bachelor's degree within 2 years and be considered a full-time student by the university. And similar to the ASCP and SOAR programs, you will be a full-time cadet for the Air Force ROTC and a full-time student. This program also does not allow a second bachelor's degree or a higher level master's degree. All right, so what is a POCERP program and what makes it different from ASCP and SOAR? So it is similar in the aspect that you'll be removed from active duty and you'll go into school for a full-time college student as an Air Force ROTC cadet, but there is no scholarship provided. So although you will get a monthly stipend that's non-taxable, you will not get an annual scholarship for tuition. So this may be a good option for somebody that wants to use their GI Bill, or if you want to do any additional research on scholarships and grants. There are plenty of scholarships and grants available for active duty military or veterans. So if you were to look in your state of preference or university of preference and look for those scholarships, you can use this program to get out of the active duty and utilize those scholarships or your GI Bill to get your undergraduate degree. And for the process for the POCERP program, it's very similar to the ASCP and SOAR program where the board meets once a year. For fiscal year of 2017, it was 100% selection rate. And for fiscal year 2018, it was 88% selection rate. All right, now that you made it to the end, I'm gonna cover some things that are very important to consider when applying for Air Force ROTC enlisted to officer programs. So one thing to remember is that when you are applying for these programs, you are getting removed from active duty status. So you will no longer be collecting military pay or benefits, and you'll be living on the civilian economy just like a typical college student. Also, another thing to note is that as an applicant, you are in charge of the completeness and correctness of your application. So make sure you take it very seriously and make sure you have a very good attention to detail. Another thing to consider is that Air Force ROTC cadets, whether you're prior enlisted or not, they're all competing for the allocation. So just because you are prior enlisted doesn't hold you higher than the other college students in Air Force ROTC. And lastly, upon your completion of Air Force ROTC, it could take up to 365 days to return to active duty. And once you get to active duty, you have to promise the Air Force 4 years of active duty service and then 4 years of reserve service. All right, guys, well, that's all I have for today. I get really excited when I talk about these scholarship programs. There's so much more of which I'm gonna cover in my future videos when it comes to medical or JAG or even just a variety of scholarship programs. So if you stay tuned, I'm gonna bring you a lot more of these videos. And if you have any specific questions or comments, please comment below and subscribe for my videos that are to come. and I will see you guys next time. Thank you for watching. Bye.